Good afternoon. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the panel on the role of the academia in regional sustainable of the regions. As was announced, the panel is organized within the United Nations office. United Nations office at Geneva and all the academies of arts and science. A joint project that aims to present documents for the global leadership project in the conference that will be held in Geneva in the 27-28 of October. Before starting, let me introduce the participants. First, Mrs. Karin Markides.
Professor Markides at the moment is in a board meeting in Armenia, in Yerevan, but she's going to join us at any moment when she'll finish the board meeting.
Okay, you understood from Professor Eden Mahmoud that Mrs. Markides will join us afterwards. She is the president of the Black Sea in the exercise that will start this autumn.
But at the same time, she is the president of the American University in Armenia.
Yes. Professor Pericles Mitkas, that is the actual president of the Black Sea University Network.
Hello to everybody. It's good to see you.
Also president of the Higher Education Council in Greece. Professor Magdalena Platis, that is the vice rector of the University of Bucharest.
Good afternoon.
Professor Mihai Gârțu, that is the vice rector at the University of Ovidius Constanța.
Hello.
Professor Eden Mahmoud, professor at the University of Ovidius, general secretary of the Black Sea University Network.
Hello, everybody.
Professor Elena Helera from the University of Transylvania Brașov, who had long activity in university regional cooperation. Professor Răileanu Seleș, Monica Răileanu Seleș.
Hello. Hello.
Also from the Transylvania University in Brașov, director of the Institute of Research and Development of Transylvania University. Next to me is Dr. Oana Brânda, university lecturer, expert in communication in our Institute for Advanced Studies in the Levant Culture and Civilization.
Hello, everyone.
And finally, me, that I'm Dan Grigorescu, professor for many years at the University of Bucharest, now less than 50. And now scientific director at the Institute Levant. What I suggest, following the recommended procedure for developing the panels, I will make it in the first part introductory to the panel, in which I'll try very briefly to raise the main points in this role of the academia. I would say mostly universities, because in this type of project, according to our experience, academia means universities with their professors, students and researchers. So to introduce this panel. I would say that for the very beginning that universities and the regions, the two parts of this panel under discussion, needs each other. University with its activity in education, in developing professional training, in promoting science and culture, is deeply interested to know the realities of the regions. And the regions are the places in which all the realities that we may say they cover practically all the fields that are taught in the universities are the proper place to know them. On the other side, the regions need very much consultancy, expertise from the university to develop their project, and especially, I will stress on this, to promote science, to understand better the scientific and cultural values they host in their region. They host, I mean, the places of special natural and cultural interest that are part of the local heritage that represent, as you will see, one of the ways of promoting this cooperation between universities and the regions. For the universities, the regions represent real open space laboratories, living laboratories in which these realities might be very well known and, of course, known to be applied, to be used in the educational programs, to be adapted in the practical placement of the students and so on. Due to the gain reputation in education, in training, in, as I said, in promoting science and culture, the universities are better placed than the other institution to enhance the socio-economic development in the regions. Science and culture are indeed the most important fields in which universities might contribute to the development in a region. Raising the awareness of the local communities on the natural and cultural values they host, meaning places of special, as I said before, or special interest, natural, meaning biological, ecological, also historical and cultural, represent concrete ways of successful intervention of the universities in the region. By this raising the awareness, the local people in front with their authorities become more conscient on the values of the needs for the protection of them and to value them by tourism, by education, and with positive effects on the local communities. As you can see from the slide, there are needs but also reciprocal benefits for the both parts, universities and the regions represented by local authorities. I will not insist on the aspect, you can read. Indeed, for the university, the main aspect important is that by this cooperation might be created a special environment for the university, as I said, a living laboratory, in which university can act with students, of course, in close cooperation with authorities. And this will very positively affect the education, especially in the practical aspects, on the what we may call the hands-on learning, studying the different fields in a very direct link with the object. The benefit might is also because it might generate new jobs for the student, increase the employability. And of course, not in the last point, is that with such a cooperation, the university position in the society is enhanced. It's increased very much. Because, as I said, the regions really needs such involvement. On the other side, for the local, for the regions represented by local authorities, this can increase the visibility of the region on the international world. Can sustain very much their own projects, much more holistically approach to the real needs of the region. And of course, this will also contribute to better environmental protection and valuing of the natural resources. So, from this cooperation between universities and regions, it resulted very important achievements in the world. The most important is the creation some 15 years ago. The next, the other one. Some 15 years ago, a UNESCO Global Geopark network that started with a European Global Geopark network that you can see here. Is an actual map of celebrating the 20 years of the first creation of a European Geopark.
Excuse me, doctor. That oh yes, now we are able to see.
That has now not less than 80 European Geoparks, and 15 years ago, in 2005, it gave rise to the global geopark, meaning geoparks spread in all the other continents. So many of these geoparks are based on university academic involvement in advising local communities, as I said, mostly on the values of the regions, of the natural and cultural sites in the region. There is really an explosion of the geoparks in the world, because it's a real very good way of putting in value the resort.